Welcome to Relaxing Boutique Channel. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a bit challenging. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury, but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies, and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. The Masquerade Ball of Venice. Chapter 1. The Mysterious Invitation. In the vibrant and bustling city of Venice, where the ancient canals whispered stories of the past and the air was thick with anticipation for the annual carnival, Lucia, a gifted mask maker, lived and worked in her small but charming studio. Nestled in the heart of the city, her shop was a treasure trove of masks, each a masterpiece showcasing her exceptional skill and creativity. Lucia, known for her intricate designs and exquisite craftsmanship, was a master at capturing the essence of the carnival in her work. Lucia's days were filled with the joy of creation, her hands deftly shaping and painting masks that would soon adorn the faces of revelers. Her masks were not just disguises, they were pieces of art, imbued with stories and emotions. But amidst her busy preparations for the carnival, Lucia stumbled upon something that piqued her curiosity and set her on an unexpected path. One evening, as Lucia was tidying her workshop, she noticed a peculiar envelope tucked away under a pile of colorful fabric scraps. Intrigued, she picked it up, marveling at its fine paper and elegant script. The envelope was sealed with a wax stamp, depicting an intricate mask, a symbol that Lucia had never seen before. Inside the envelope was an invitation, written in a flowing, ornate script. The words invited her to a masquerade ball, but not just any ball. This was a secretive event, one that seemed shrouded in mystery. The invitation provided no details about the host or the other guests, only a cryptic location and a time. What intrigued Lucia the most was that no one in her circle of acquaintances, many of whom were well-versed in the city's social events, had ever mentioned such a ball. Driven by curiosity and a sense of adventure, Lucia decided to find this hidden masquerade ball. She reasoned that it could be a wonderful opportunity to showcase her masks, perhaps to an exclusive clientele. But more than that, there was a whisper of something deeper, a story waiting to be uncovered, and Lucia was determined to discover it. The next morning, with the invitation in hand, Lucia set out to unravel the mystery. She started by visiting some of the oldest and most knowledgeable residents of Venice, the gondoliers. They were the keepers of the city's secrets, guiding their gondolas through the labyrinthine canals, privy to the tales and histories hidden within the crumbling facades and shadowed waters. Lucia approached an old gondolier named Marco, whose eyes sparkled with the wisdom of years spent navigating the canals. She showed him the invitation, hoping he might recognize the seal or the location. Marco studied the invitation with keen interest, his brow furrowing in thought. He told her that the seal resembled a symbol belonging to an ancient Venetian family, long thought extinct. The location, he said, was in one of the more secluded parts of the city, where the canals twisted like serpents, hiding their secrets from the uninitiated. Emboldened by this information, Lucia delved deeper into the heart of Venice. She wandered through narrow alleys and over quaint bridges, each step taking her further into the city's rich tapestry of history and intrigue. Along the way, she met artists, poets, and musicians, each adding pieces to the puzzle with their stories and insights. They spoke of a time when masked balls were not just social gatherings, but elaborate spectacles where hidden truths were revealed and forbidden romances flourished. Lucia's journey also led her to the archives of Venice, a treasure trove of documents and maps. There, amidst the musty tomes and fading manuscripts, she discovered references to a mysterious masquerade ball, an event that had seemingly vanished from history. The ball was said to be a night of enchantment, where the participants wore masks not just to conceal their identities, but to free themselves from the constraints of their lives, if only for a few hours. As she pieced together the clues, Lucia felt as though she was being drawn into a world that straddled the line between reality and fantasy. The carnival itself was a time when the city transformed, when the ordinary became extraordinary, and the impossible seemed within reach. But this masquerade ball seemed to be something even more, a gateway to a hidden side of Venice that few knew existed, and in the days leading up to the ball, Lucia's excitement grew. She decided to create a special mask for the occasion, one that would capture the essence of her journey and the mysteries she hoped to uncover. She worked tirelessly, her hands shaping and painting with a passion that she had never felt before. The mask was a masterpiece, a fusion of traditional Venetian style and her own unique flair. It was adorned with intricate patterns and symbols that mirrored the cryptic nature of the invitation. Finally, the night of the masquerade ball arrived. Dressed in her finest gown and wearing the mask she had lovingly crafted, Lucia felt a thrilling mix of anticipation and nervousness. She made her way through the city, the streets alive with the energy of the carnival. The sounds of laughter, music, and the clinking of glasses filled the air, a symphony of celebration that echoed through the canals. As she followed the directions on the invitation, Lucia found herself navigating a series of narrow, winding canals. The further she went, the quieter it became, until the only sound was the gentle lapping of water against the walls of the ancient buildings. The flickering light of her lantern danced on the water, casting eerie shadows that seemed to play tricks on her eyes. Finally, she arrived at the location indicated on the invitation, a grand palazzo that seemed to rise out of the water, its windows aglow with soft, inviting light. A sense of awe washed over Lucia as she approached, her heart beating with excitement. She was about to step into a world of mystery and enchantment, a night that promised to reveal the secrets hidden within the heart of Venice. Lucia took a deep breath and stepped forward, crossing the threshold into the unknown. The world behind her faded away, and she found herself enveloped in the magic of the masquerade ball. Chapter 2 Through the Canals of Venice. Lucia's journey to uncover the secrets of the masquerade ball took her through the heart of Venice, a city as enigmatic as it was beautiful. The labyrinthine canals and narrow alleyways of Venice were like veins, pulsing with centuries of history, secrets, and stories waiting to be discovered. As Lucia navigated these paths, the city began to reveal its hidden layers to her. Her first stop was the bustling Rialto Market, where the air was rich with the aromas of fresh seafood, spices, and ripe fruits. Here, amidst the chatter of merchants and the calls of gondoliers, Lucia hoped to glean information about the secretive event. She conversed with the vendors, who, while unaware of the mysterious ball, shared tales of past carnivals, nights filled with intrigue and romance, where the masks allowed the wearers to be anyone they desired. As Lucia moved through the city, she couldn't help but be drawn in by the splendor of Venice during Carnival. The streets were alive with performers, jesters, musicians, and acrobats, all adorned in vibrant costumes and masks, each a piece of art. The energy of the carnival was infectious, and Lucia found herself swept up in the celebrations. Her quest then led her to the quieter, less traveled parts of Venice. In these secluded areas, away from the throngs of the main squares and the grandeur of the palaces, Lucia discovered the more intimate side of the city. She walked along canals lined with old, weathered buildings, their facades telling stories of the city's glorious past and its slow surrender to the ravages of time and water. It was in one of these quieter neighborhoods that Lucia encountered an old gondolier named Antonio. With his deep knowledge of Venice's waterways, Antonio was a guardian of the city's secrets. Lucia showed him the mysterious invitation, and his eyes lit up with recognition. He spoke of a hidden network of canals that led to an ancient part of the city where few ventured. This, he believed, could be where the elusive ball was to be held. Taking his advice, Lucia hired a gondola to explore these hidden canals. As she glided through the water, the city transformed around her. The grandeur of the popular areas gave way to a more mysterious Venice, one where the silence was only broken by the gentle splash of the gondolier's oar. The walls of the buildings here whispered of secret rendezvous, hidden affairs, and forbidden love stories, fueling Lucia's imagination and determination to uncover the ball's location. During her exploration, Lucia met various intriguing characters, each adding depth to the tapestry of her journey. There was a mysterious masked woman singing a haunting melody from her balcony, her song seeming to speak directly to Lucia's heart. There was an old historian in a tucked-away library who shared legends of ancient masquerade balls where masked nobles would escape the confines of their societal roles. One evening, as dusk turned the sky a deep shade of crimson, Lucia found herself in a forgotten piazza. Here, she encountered a group of elderly Venetians, their faces etched with the wisdom of the ages. They spoke of the city's golden age, of grand balls and splendid galas, where hidden behind the masks, true feelings were expressed and destinies were altered. They recalled tales passed down through generations of a mysterious masquerade ball held in a secluded palazzo, a night where time stood still and the normal rules of society were suspended. These stories only fueled Lucia's resolve to find the ball. She felt as though she was being pulled deeper into the heart of Venice, each discovery leading her closer to her destination. The city itself seemed to be guiding her, its whispers becoming clearer with each passing day. As the carnival reached its peak, the atmosphere in Venice became even more electric. The night air was thick with anticipation and excitement. Masks of all shapes and sizes, from the simple to the grotesque, from the elegant to the outlandish, paraded through the streets. The city was a canvas, and its inhabitants the vibrant colors painting a picture of revelry and mystery. Finally, after days of searching and following the clues woven through the fabric of Venice, Lucia found herself standing before an ancient palazzo, its facade reflecting the moonlight. It was hidden at the end of a narrow canal, a gem tucked away from the usual paths trodden by tourists and locals alike. The palazzo was both imposing and beautiful, its walls holding the secrets of centuries. Its windows were aglow, casting a warm light over the water, beckoning Lucia closer. A sense of awe washed over her as she realized that her journey through the heart of Venice had led her to this moment. She had found the location of the mysterious masquerade ball. Standing before the palazzo, Lucia felt a mix of excitement and apprehension. She was about to step into a world of enchantment, a night that promised to reveal the secrets hidden within the heart of Venice and within herself. Her heart beat with anticipation as she adjusted her mask and prepared to enter the masquerade ball. Chapter 3. A Tale of Love and Intrigue. In the depths of Venice, amidst its winding canals and shadowed alleys, Lucia's journey to uncover the truth behind the mysterious masquerade ball led her to a world of intrigue, where stories of the past intertwined with the present. The more she delved into the city's secrets, the more she discovered about an age-old tale of love and betrayal, a story that seemed to be the heart of the masquerade ball itself. The tale was as old as Venice. It spoke of a forbidden romance between a noble woman, Isabella, and a talented young artist, Lorenzo. Their love was a flame that burned brightly in the shadows of Venice's opulence, a passion that defied the rigid conventions of their time. Isabella and Lorenzo's story was one of secret rendezvous in hidden gardens, of stolen moments under the moonlit sky, and of a love so profound that it transcended the boundaries of status and wealth. Lucia learned that Isabella and Lorenzo had created a secret masquerade ball as a haven for their love, a night where they could be together, their true identities hidden behind masks. This ball became a legend, a night of freedom and passion where the constraints of societal roles were cast aside. As Lucia continued to explore Venice, she discovered that the story of Isabella and Lorenzo was not just a tale of the past. The masquerade ball was a tradition that had been kept alive through the centuries, a yearly event where the story of the star-crossed lovers was celebrated, and their spirit of defiance and love was rekindled. Lucia's journey took her to the archives of a forgotten library, where she found letters and diaries from those who had attended the ball over the years. Each entry spoke of the enchantment of the night, of the sense of stepping into another world where anything was possible. The writers described the thrill of anonymity, the freedom to express their true selves without fear of judgment or consequence. Intrigued by these accounts, Lucia sought out the descendants of those who had been part of Isabella and Lorenzo's circle. She met with elderly Venetians who shared stories passed down through their families. They spoke of a grand palazzo where the ball was held, a place where time seemed to stand still, and the air was thick with the magic of the past. One evening, as Lucia wandered the moonlit streets of Venice, she encountered an old woman who claimed to be a direct descendant of Isabella. The woman, adorned in a shawl that seemed as ancient as the city itself, had eyes that sparkled with secrets. She told Lucia that the masquerade ball was more than just a celebration of love. It was a ritual that kept the spirit of Venice alive, a night where the city's heart beat strongest. The old woman shared with Lucia a piece of the original invitation to the first ball, a delicate piece of parchment that held the essence of the past. She explained that the ball was a reminder that beneath the masks we are all bound by the same desires and fears, the same longing for connection and understanding. As the night of the masquerade ball approached, Lucia felt as though she was becoming a part of Venice's history, a thread woven into the city's rich tapestry. She felt a connection to Isabella and Lorenzo, their story resonating with her own desires and dreams. Lucia decided to create a mask for the ball that would honor their story, a mask that symbolized the timeless nature of love. She worked tirelessly, pouring her heart into the design. The mask was a masterpiece of craftsmanship, adorned with symbols of love and freedom, its colors reflecting the moonlit waters of Venice's canals. On the eve of the ball, Lucia stood before the mirror, her mask in hand. She saw not just her reflection, but the echoes of all those who had come before her, the lovers, dreamers, and rebels who had found refuge in the anonymity of the masquerade. She felt a sense of belonging, a deep connection to the city and its hidden stories. Dressed in her finest gown and wearing the mask she had lovingly created, Lucia made her way to the grand palazzo where the ball was to be held. The city was alive with anticipation, the air filled with the sound of laughter and music, the streets a river of color and light. As she entered the palazzo, Lucia was struck by its beauty. The grand hall was illuminated by hundreds of candles, their flickering light casting shadows that danced across the walls. The guests were a swirl of color and mystery, their masks and costumes a testament to the enduring allure of the carnival. Lucia moved through the crowd, her senses heightened by the beauty and mystery that surrounded her. She watched as people danced and laughed, their identities hidden, their spirits free. The atmosphere was intoxicating, a blend of excitement and intrigue that enveloped Lucia in its embrace. As she wandered the halls of the palazzo, Lucia felt as though she was walking through a dream, each step taking her deeper into the heart of Venice. She felt the presence of Isabella and Lorenzo, their love story a whisper in the air, a melody that played softly in the background. The night unfolded like a tapestry, each moment a thread in the intricate design of the ball. Lucia danced with strangers, shared laughs and stories, and felt the thrill of anonymity. She was no longer just Lucia, the mask maker. She was a part of something larger, a participant in a story that had spanned centuries. As the night drew to a close, Lucia stood on the balcony of the palazzo, looking out over the city. Venice was a jewel in the moonlight, its canals and streets a maze of beauty and mystery. She felt a profound sense of gratitude for the journey that had brought her to this moment, for the stories she had uncovered, and for the connection she had found to the city and its past. The masquerade ball was more than just an event, it was a celebration of life, love, and the enduring spirit of Venice. It was a night where the past and present merged, where the lines between reality and fantasy blurred, and where the heart of the city beat strongest. As Lucia removed her mask, she knew that she would carry the magic of the night with her always. She had discovered the secret of the masquerade ball, and in doing so, she had uncovered a piece of herself. Venice, with all its beauty and mystery, had become a part of her, and she a part of it. Chapter 4. The Night of the Masquerade. As Lucia entered the grand hall of the palazzo, a sense of wonder washed over her. The masquerade ball was a spectacle beyond her wildest imaginings, a tableau of history and fantasy coming to life. The walls of the palazzo were adorned with rich tapestries and paintings that told stories of Venice's illustrious past. Chandeliers hung from the ceiling, casting a warm, golden light over the guests who swirled around the room in a dance of colors and shadows. The air was filled with the melodies of a string quartet, their music a perfect accompaniment to the evening's mysterious allure. The guests, adorned in their elaborate costumes and masks, moved with an elegance and freedom that only the anonymity of the masquerade could provide. Lucia was captivated by the sight, each mask she passed revealing a new character, each costume a work of art reflecting the creativity and spirit of the wearer. As she moved through the crowd, Lucia felt the thrill of being part of this timeless tradition. Her mask, a creation of her own hands, was more than just a disguise. It was a key to a hidden world, a world where the constraints of ordinary life were lifted, and one could be whoever they dreamed to be. Throughout the night, Lucia encountered a variety of intriguing characters. There was the mysterious lady in the emerald gown, her mask adorned with feathers, who spoke in riddles and moved like a shadow. There was the jovial man in the jester's attire, his laughter infectious, his stories of Venice's history captivating. Each encounter was a piece of the puzzle that was the masquerade ball, a glimpse into the lives and stories that intersected in this magical space. As the night progressed, Lucia found herself drawn to the grand balcony overlooking the moonlit canals. There, she met a stranger whose presence seemed both out of time and entirely at home in the setting of the ball. His mask was simple yet elegant, a stark contrast to the more elaborate disguises around them. His eyes, visible behind the mask, held a depth and understanding that intrigued Lucia. They spoke of many things: the history of Venice, the art of mask making, the beauty of the carnival. But more than the words, it was the connection they shared that was remarkable. The stranger seemed to understand the essence of the masquerade, the blend of reality and illusion, the freedom and the connection it offered. As they conversed, Lucia felt as if she were peeling away the layers of a mystery, each word, each glance, revealing something deeper, something more profound. The stranger's insights into the traditions and stories of Venice resonated with her own experiences and the journey that had led her to this night. The evening reached its zenith with a grand waltz, the guests pairing off in a dance that was both an echo of the past and a celebration of the present. Lucia and the stranger joined the dance, moving together in a rhythm that felt as natural as breathing. The world around them seemed to fade away, leaving only the music, the dance, and the connection they shared. The dance was a journey in itself, a passage through time and emotion that left Lucia breathless. She realized that this moment was the culmination of her quest, not just to find the masquerade ball, but to discover a deeper part of herself. The ball was a mirror, reflecting the desires and dreams of those who attended, a space where the hidden parts of oneself could be revealed and embraced. As the night drew to a close, the magic of the masquerade began to wane. The guests, reluctant to leave the enchantment behind, lingered in the grand hall, savoring the final moments of freedom and mystery. Lucia, too, was hesitant to let go of the night, to remove her mask and step back into the ordinary world. She and the stranger parted with a final dance, a silent promise that the memory of this night would linger long after the masks were removed and the costumes put away. There was a sense of understanding between them, a recognition that, though they might never meet again, they had shared something extraordinary, something that transcended the boundaries of the masquerade. As Lucia made her way home through the quiet streets of Venice, the city seemed different to her. It was as if she was seeing it through new eyes, eyes that had been open to the magic and mystery that lay beneath the surface. The canals and alleyways were no longer just pathways through a city, they were the veins of a living, breathing entity, a city that had embraced her and revealed its secrets. The masquerade ball had been more than just an event, it had been a journey into the heart of Venice and into the heart of Lucia herself. She had uncovered the stories and legends that pulsed through the city's streets, had experienced the freedom and connection that the carnival offered, and had discovered a part of herself that she had never known. As Lucia removed her mask, she knew that she would carry the magic of the night with her always. The masquerade ball had changed her, had shown her the power of mystery and the beauty of connection. Venice, with all its shadows and light, its history and its dreams, had become a part of her, and she a part of it.